गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, बॉर्निंग इन मेडिकल कॉम्प्लेक्सेस टू। फ्रॉम द लास्ट सिक्स क्लासेस वी आर डिस्कसिंग बॉर्निंग इन मेडिकल कॉम्प्लेक्सेस टू चैप्टर। सो इन कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ दैट टुडे I am going to have seventh lecture on bone metal complexes too. So last class I have covered two topics, inter-electronic repulsion parameters. And the second topic is spin orbital coupling parameters. These are the two topics I have covered in the last session. Now, in this session of class, I will going to explain you weak crystal field effect. Effect on terms. The crystal fields will affect on terms and get splits into different new energy levels, and that's how it is taking place. We are going to discuss in this video. So before starting of that, just I will brief the first last session class topics: inter-electronic repulsion. Repulsion parameters. So here we have two types of inter-electron repulsion parameters. One is Condon-Shotley parameters such as F0, F2, F4 and Rakoff parameters of A, B, C. And these can be interrelated with A is equal to F0 minus 49 F4 and B can be equal to F2 minus 5 F4 and C can be related as 35 F4. They can interrelate Rakoff parameter to Condon-Shotley parameter, Condon-Shotley parameters, Rakoff parameters, where here we have more advantages from them. Rakoff parameters. What the Rakoff parameter advantage? When we conclude, you will come to know. And the expressions of different energies of terms in Rakoff parameters is, for example, if you are going with it, D2 electronic configuration terms, 3F, 3P, 1D, 1G, 1S terms expression, if we go, the energy of 3F term will be equal to A minus 8B. The energy of 3P term is equal to A plus 7B. And the energy of 1D term is equal to A minus 3B minus 2C. And the energy of 1G term is equal to A plus 4B plus 2C. And the energy of 1S term is equal to A plus 14B plus 7C. Thus the expressions they given. And when we look into the energy differences of two highly spin multiplicity terms, the 3F comma 3P are the highest spin multiplicity terms. In those terms, energy difference, if we calculate, it would be 15B, or we can say that it is a function of B parameter function. So like this, For any configuration terms, the term difference, the highest spin momentum term difference will be the function of B. It would be function of B. So that is the one we observed, we can observe. The energy between two different terms such as 3F and 1D, it would be the function of B and C. It would be the function of B and C. Any two terms energy difference if we see, it would be the function of B and C. Where with these two respects, we can say that the A parameter will not have any importance. The A parameter is just to represent the giving expression for the energy of single term, it would be having importance. But when we calculate the energy difference, it would get cancelled in each time when we calculate the energy difference between two terms. So either the energy difference would be equal to the function of B, or it would be B comma C function. So there is an more importance is reflecting the energy difference having the more importance for the B term, having the B term. And when we observe the B value in 3D, 4D, 5D metal complexes, the 3D metal complex having the C by B value approximately approximately of 4.0, and it would have the B value approximately 1000 per centimeter. Whereas for the 4D, 5D, the B value and C by B value are decreased. This is because of the size deviation from 3D metal ions to 4D, 5D. The 3D metal ions are smaller size metal ions, whereas 4D, 5D are larger size metal ions. As they having larger size 4D, 5D metal ions, they counts for lesser electron-electron interaction. They will create electron-to-electron gap. There will be in an electron-electron energy difference will be large. The electron-electron interactions will be gets down when there is an larger size atoms. So as the 4D, 5D having larger size, one electron to other electron gap will be creates. The interaction of negative-negative interactions will be gets lowered. So far, the inter-electron repulsions get lowers. The inter-electron repulsions when get lowers, it reflecting parameter values also will get lowers. So thus here the parameter B getting decreased. And and when we observe the B value in different oxidation states of metal ion, as the oxidation state getting increased, the B value is getting increased. When we increasing the oxidation state of metal ion, the B value is getting increased. The increase of B value is also counts for the inter-electron repulsions, where as the oxidation state increases, the nuclear effect on valence electronic configuration get increases. There the size of the atom, the metal atom will get decreases. When the metal atom size is getting decreased or getting synchronized, or when it is getting smaller in size, electron to electron, the interactions, the energy difference or close packing it creates, the electron to electron close packing it creates in smaller size atoms, right? So as the oxidation state increases, sizes get decreases of metal atom. So far the electron to electron gap will be furtherly decreases. When electron to electron gap decreases, there will be closer interaction of one electron to other electron, it takes place. When there is an closer interactions are taking place between one electron to other electron, the negative negative interactions will getting more and more, get enhances. So once the negative negative interactions are getting increases, the inter-electron repulsions will be get enhances. That reflecting parameters such as B value also get increases, right? And all these, all the statements of values, all the statements of these three, where the energy difference having an importance of B parameter, and the 3D to 4D, 5D Matlab, giving the importance of B value, suggesting the B value importance, and the metal charge increase also suggesting the B value importance, where after all getting these three points, one can suggest that the B value is the direct impression of interelectronic repulsions. When the B value is increasing, interelectron repulsions are getting increased. The interelectron repulsion when getting decreased, the B value is getting decreasing. So where it is saying that the interelectron repulsions are direct indications of B value. The B value when it is increases, interelectron repulsions will get increases. When the B value get decreases, interelectron repulsion is getting decreased. So that effective B term, B parameter is there, and thus B parameter is from the Rakoff parameter. The B parameter is one of the Rakoff parameter. So having such effective importance in interactor and repulsion, B Rakoff parameter, we mostly consider in calculation of terms energy and energy difference, we will go with the Rakoff parameters, right? In next we have spin orbital coupling parameters. Spin orbital coupling parameters. And here the spin orbital coupling parameter, as the coupling schemes are two different in spin orbital coupling, as it is JJ and LS, there are the two parameters we can also expect here in defining the spin orbital coupling. So thus two parameters are zeta and lambda, zeta and lambda, and where the zeta is reflecting the single electron spin orbital coupling. And lambda reflecting the multi-electron spin orbital coupling. Right. And here the zeta is the has the expression of E square H square by 2 into M square C square A naught into z to the power of 4 by n to the power of 3 l into l plus 1 into l plus half, where E suggests the charge of the electron, H suggests the Planck constant, M suggests the mass of the electron, C suggests the velocity of the electron, A naught is the Bohr radii, and Z is indicating the nuclei charge, and N is reflecting the principal quantum number, L is reflecting the azimuthal quantum value of electronic configuration. And the relation between lambda to zeta is suggested as plus or minus zeta by 2s, where s is nothing but spin of the electronic configuration, and where the positive value for less than half filled configuration, and negative values are indicating more than half filled electronic configuration, and these lambda and zeta, when we are going for the states, the states are the newly generated energy levels from the terms, and with the effect of spin orbital coupling. With the effect of spin orbital coupling, terms are getting splitted and generated states. And thus states, if you want to count the number of states generating from the terms, that may be equal to the number of states can be equal to 2L plus 1 or 2S plus 1, which are is minimum, which are is minimum. Thus value is indicating the number of states from the term, from the term, from the term, the number of states arise is equal to 2L plus 1 or 2S plus 1. It nothing but the number of states is equal to orbital multiplicity or state multiplicity, whichever is a minimum, right? So here when we express the energy of state, energy of states, the state energy can be equal to lambda by 2 into j plus 1 minus L into L plus 1 minus S into S plus 1. Minus S into S plus 1. And when we want to count the energy difference between two states, that can be equal to lambda into j plus 1. Lambda into j plus 1. So with these two equations, we can calculate any state's energy or any state's energy, any two states' energy difference, right? So this is how the spin orbital coupling parameters are there. Now I will going to explain you today's new topic, weak crystal field effect. Weak crystal field effect on terms. Actually, the terms arises from the electronic configuration. Due to the inter-electronic repulsions. With the inter-electron repulsion perturbation, electronic configuration destabilizes and get participated in splitting, generates terms, and thus newly generated terms, when affected by weak crystal or ligand field, it generates new energy levels. New energy levels. The terms in metal complexes, right? The metal complexes having terms, when ligands are interacting, the ligand field will affect onto the terms and destabilizes. Thus, destabilized terms will overcome the destabilizing factor, weak crystal field effect. They will get undergo in splitting, generates new energy levels. Thus, newly generated energy levels will actually affect the weak crystal field, actually affects onto the orbital multiplicity. Orbital multiplicity of terms. The crystal field effects onto the orbital multiplicity of terms, but it never interacts with the never interacts with spin multiplicity. Spin multiplicity. So with the effect of weak crystal field effect, the orbital degeneracy will be get lifted. With the effect of lifted orbital multiplicity, there is new energy levels generated, and thus newly generated energy levels will carry the same spin multiplicity as from the mother or parent terms. What is the parent term having the spin multiplicity? Just it carried forward to the newly generated energy levels, but the orbital multiplicity will get disturbed and get splitted into new orbital splitting, right? Where newly generated energy levels may be singly degenerated, Thus, singly degenerated energy levels will be symboled with the help of capital A or capital B, and they may be doubly degenerated levels, energy levels. That doubly degenerated energy level will be indicated with E symbol, capital E symbol, and it may also be triply degenerated energy levels, and thus triply degenerated energy levels termed with the capital T. Capital T, where in the octahedral field, the octahedral crystal field, the symbols A, B, E, T are having the G in denominator, in bottom, where in tetrahedral crystal field, the G will be absent in the bottom of these terms, where the new terms A, B, E, T are called as Mulliken symbols. Will be said as Mulliken symbols. The effect of crystal field can be comparative as the crystal field effect on orbitals, since the crystal field what is affecting on terms will be effect similar will effects onto the orbitals, right? Thus orbital crystal field effect we were studied in the bonding in metal complexes one, where we have seen the different d orbital splittings with the effect of different crystal field, different ligand field, the d orbital splittings are we observed. The effect of crystal field when we observe in the d orbital splitting, the ligands are upon influencing, when the ligands are approaching towards the metal atom, the metal valency electrons will interact with the ligand-donated electrons, and thus metal valency electrons and ligand-donated electrons will get repulsive interaction, and thus repulsive interaction will destabilize the valency electronic configuration, valency orbitals of the metal ion. So thus valency orbitals will undergo in splitting to overcome the destabilizing factor, and thus splitting of valency d orbitals will be have variant with respect of their ligand field effect. So in that ligand field interaction on d orbital also, the spin of the d electronic configuration, d orbital electronic configuration never disturbs, where here the terms also, the spin multiplicity of the terms also never be influenced by the weak crystal field effect or weak ligand field effect, where as such the d orbitals gets splitted, orbitals degeneracy of d orbital is lifted, 5 degenerated orbitals are getting splitted into triplet, doublet or singlet, like that, right? In octahedral crystal field, the d orbital, 5 degenerated d orbitals are get splitted into triply degenerated state and doubly degenerated state, like that the orbitals degeneracy will be get splitted. So here the terms also will participate similar type of splitting, and the orbital multiplicity will be get influenced here of the terms orbital multiplicity also similarly get affected by the ligand fields, right? So in comparatively we will go to study the weak crystal field on terms, will be comparatively go with the weak crystal field effect on orbitals, because the orbital will have similar characters with the terms, right? So the orbital degeneracy, the orbital multiplicity and term orbital multiplicity will be similar, right? So once if we start, you will come to know exactly how it is similar. So now coming to the S term effect weak crystal field effect on S term. Where we come to know the S will have orbital angular momentum value of zero, right? So similar to that, the S orbital when it comes, it has the orbital quantum number of zero, azimuthal quantum number of zero. This azimuthal quantum number of zero, or even if we are go with the orbital angular momentum of S orbital, that also will be zero. So having same orbital multiplicity 0 0, the orbital splitting, S orbital splitting is very much comparative to the S term splitting, as the S orbital get participated in ligand field effect or crystal field effect. With the same effect, it is the orbital the ligand fields creates onto the S term also. The ligands, how does affecting on S term, will similarly affects the S term, right? So here, as L is equal to zero of S orbital, these S orbital can be said as singly degenerated state. Degenerated orbital. S orbital is singly degenerated orbital, or it also can be said as non-degenerated orbital. Since as it is having L is equal to zero, there is no suborbitals. There is no suborbitals in S orbital. When it comes to an L is equal to 1 p orbital, the p orbital will consist three suborbitals, where px, py, pz. Px, py, pz. So once if we say that p orbital, it can be a triply degenerated state where it counts for the three suborbitals of px, py, pz, right? Where when it comes to the s orbital L value is zero and there is no suborbital, so it never counts for any suborbital group. So it is an one orbital state of S orbital. So it will be said as singly degenerated orbital, or it can be said as non-degenerated. It cannot be split. It is not a group to get split, to get further different groups. So here it is a non-degenerated state. It cannot be split. So far it is a non-degenerated state. With non-degeneracy of S orbital, right, the orbital degeneracy is zero here. Non-degenerate nothing but it is zero orbital multiplicity. With this effect, the S orbital with the effect of ligand field, or you can say that crystal field, it just enhances energy and the excited energy level will symboled with either A1 or A1G. A1 is symbol used in tetrahedral ligand field. In octahedral ligand field, it's symboled with G. The G denomination suggests the ligand fields in inversion center symmetry character of inversion center. So in tetrahedral there is no inversion center. So far the G denomination is eliminated here, absent here, where octahedral having inversion center. So the symbol A1 will have in bottom G symbol, right? G term will have, right? So similar to S orbital, G term is also a non-degenerated or we can say that singly degenerate. Singly degenerated state, singly degenerated term, singly degenerated term. So as it have the similarity of orbital multiplicity from the s orbital, so the splitting pattern of term can be similar to the s orbital. So therefore the s term also never undergo in splitting and the energy will exists so the new energy level, new energy level will symbol with capital A1 in tetrahedral crystal field when the ligand field is octahedral, it symbolized with A1G. So then the splitting, the s orbital s term not splitting is indicating that the all the ligands on s term is equally in all orientation, it equally affecting on s orbital, right? The ligand effect on s orbital in every direction will be uniform. The uniform ligand effect on s orbital will makes to never split, never undergoing splitting. So just the effect of ligand, the s term will get destabilizes, so it rises its energy and thus newly generated level will be indicated as A1 or A1G. So same to that, the weak crystal field effect on P term when we study P term, and here the P term orbital multiplicity, if we say the orbital multiplicity of orbital angular momentum of P term is L is equal to 1, where P orbital orbital angular momentum value is 1. Thus also the P orbital also having the same orbital angular momentum, L is equal to 1. So when that happens, the S orbital as it is having L is equal to 1, it is counts for the 3 suborbital. It consisting 3 suborbitals. Where thus 3 orbitals will say P orbital to be triply degenerated orbital. Where the P orbital, now we can say that triply degenerated orbital. So when that is happens, here the ligand effect or crystal field effect on P term can possible to get splitting of P orbital into different energy levels, different degenerated energy levels. But when it come to an effect of ligand, when we say that octahedral crystal field, it is affecting on P orbital. The P orbital structures, when we observe the PX orbital, if this is X axis, this is Y axis, it having the lobes along the X axis. This is PX, where is come to an PY orbital. The PY orbital consists the will have the whole will have the orbitals globes along the y axis. When it comes to an pz orbital, it have the lobes along the z orbital. This is y, this is x, right? So all the px, py, pz orbital lobes are along the axis. All the lobes of px, py, pz orbitals are along the axis only. So now incorporating this all three orbitals in one diagram, it would be like this. It may looks like this, where the metal, if it having x axis like this, y axis like this, and z axis like this. This is x, this is y, and this is z. There the px lobes will be along the x axis, and the py lobes along the y axis, and along the z axis there will be pz lobes. Here this is pz, this is px, this is py, where in octahedral crystal field the ligands are along the z axis. There are two ligands along the y axis. There are two ligands along the x axis. There will be two ligands, octahedral ligand, hexacoordinated metal complex, where along each coordination axis the two ligands will be exist. Each two ligands will exist on each coordination axis. So now here, if we compare the interaction of ligand donated electron to metal p orbital electron interaction, where the p orbital, as they are having along the coordination axis, and ligands also along the coordination axis, ligand donated electrons and orbital consisting electrons, ligand donated electrons and orbital consisting electrons will have in repulsive interaction, will get in repulsive interaction, right? So each px, along the px axis there are two ligands, along the py there are two ligands, along the pz also there are two ligands, and thus means all the px, py, pz will have repulsive interaction, will have repulsive interaction with each two ligand donated electrons. So once that happens, when there is an repulsive interactions taking place between already situated valency p orbitals to ligand, there will be certainly splitting has to take place. But when we compare them, all the p orbitals, all the three p orbitals, the each p orbital having repulsive interactions with two ligands, there is no deviation in repulsive interaction quantity of repulsive interaction between orbital px orbital to py, py to pz. Because of that, as this particular px is interacting with all four electron donated by the two ligands, and py also having repulsive interaction with four electrons of two ligands, and pz also is participating repulsive interaction with two ligand four electrons, then the quantitative repulsions on all the three orbitals are one and equal. Uniformly the all the three orbitals getting repulsive interaction. So
when there is having same uniform interaction between ligand site to ligand field to orbital, there we cannot be expect any splitting. When the orbitals are differently interacting with ligand field, if one orbital having more repulsive interaction, the other two having lesser repulsive interaction, in this case the more repulsive participating orbital will be gets higher influences, higher destabilization, and it will reaches to the higher energy. Whereas the other two, if it is two, when it is participating into a lesser repulsive interaction, then thus will be slightly get stabilizes and get slower in energy. So that is not taking place here, right? The ligands, whatever it is there, all six ligands of all two ligands are interacting with each orbital, where the orbitals feels uniform repulsive interaction with all the ligand field. So thus means the p orbital also, that means the p orbital also never have any splitting, but excites its energy level. Right. So when that excites, the new energy level symbolized as it is triply degenerate level. So far we have to take T for the orbital newly energy levels. We will go with the smaller alphabets. If the term energy states to symbolize, we have to take it capital alphabets. Here orbital newly generated energy level symbol will be small t, and thus it is in a small t2 in tetrahedral, small t2g in octahedral, small t2g in octahedral. So that's how it is. So similar as p term, similar with p orbital in orbital multiplicity, the p term also never has splitting and get excited. So newly generated energy level symbolized as T2 in tetrahedral, T2G in octahedral, T2G in octahedral. T1 in tetrahedral, T1G in octahedral, T1 in tetrahedral, T1G in octahedral, T1G. Okay, right. That's how the p orbitals get interacted with the weak crystal field. Now coming to the d term. D term affecting the crystal field. Crystal field effect on d term. So the d term will have again similarities with d orbital, where d term, here we have to indicate the multiplicity n, n will be having same n, n. So the n term, np term will have same spin multiplicity. What I said, spin multiplicity never be interacted, never be disturbed. The spin multiplicity carry forward from the mother or parent term, right? Parent term having n spin multiplicity will be carry forward the newly generated energy level as n t1 or n t1g, t1g. Now n term where n term orbital multiplicity, orbital angular momentum of nd term, it has two. The d orbital angular momentum will also be two. So having similarities in orbital multiplicity from term to orbital, the d orbital splitting pattern can be similar, the d term splitting pattern can be similar as d orbital, right? So once if we come for the d orbital splitting in octahedral crystal field, the d orbital as it is an phi degenerated, it get splits into two energy levels where the ground state will have triply degenerated level t2g, and the excited energy level will have doubly degenerated level eg, right? So that is how the d orbital splitting in octahedral crystal field. Why the splitting is like this, once we observe this, also already explained in the bonding involved complexes one in semester one. Once again I am repeating that the d orbital is 5 degenerated orbital. Nothing but it consisting 5 suborbitals such as dxy, dyz, dzx, and dx square minus y square and dz square. When we go for the structures of all these, the first dx orbital has a lobes in between of x and y axis, the dxy orbital has the four lobes. Similar to that, the dyz and zx will have their lobes along in between of coordination axis. So as the these three orbitals dxy, dyz, dzx, dxy, dyz and dzx having lobes in between of coordination axis will called as non-axial orbitals. When it comes to an dx square minus y square orbital, dx square minus y square orbital, it has the lobes along the coordination axis. The four lobes of the dx square minus y square are 2-2 along each coordination axis of x and y. So this is x square minus y square, dx square minus y square. And when I draw the dz square orbital, here I will take z, x, and in between of this, if I take y, the lobe will be along the z axis there is two lobes, and spherical lobe will exist in middle. In middle there is a spherical lobe. This is what the dz square. So as the lobes along the coordination axis, the dx square minus y square and dz square orbitals will be called as axial orbitals. Right. So with the effect of these axial orientation of orbitals, the two axial orientation orbitals will be having different interaction with the six ligands of octahedral, and as dxy, dyz, dzx having non-axial lobes, the interaction of ligands with these three orbitals will be differ. So the difference how it takes place is the octahedral will be nothing but what? It is metal with six ligand sites, where the six ligands are all existing on along the coordination axis. On each coordination axis there will be two ligands. This is what octahedral crystal field. So with this octahedral crystal field along the each coordination axis two ligands, the lobes, the orbitals which consisting lobes along the ligand sites, nothing but along the coordination axis, they will get participation in repulsive interaction. The orbitals which are in between of coordination axis or away from the ligand sites, they will not have any repulsive interactions with the ligand sites. So here the non-axial orbitals such as xy, dxy, dyz, dzx has the lobes along the in between of coordination axis, and they are away from the ligand sites. So far these particular three orbitals will be never interacts with the ligand site, never will have any repulsive interaction with the ligand orbital electrons to these orbital consisting electron. So they get stabilizes and they will reaches to the lowest energy level, where the lowest energy level having three orbitals, so far it is generating a triply degenerated energy level. And next when it come to them, dx square minus y square and dz square, and they having the lobes along the coordination axis, and they are saying that axial orbitals. So thus axial orbitals along the coordination axis having the lobes along the coordination axis, which means towards the ligand sites they has the lobes. So when dx square minus y square dz square having the lobes along towards the ligand site, the ligand orbital electrons and thus orbital consisting electrons will participate in repulsive interaction, will get repulsive interaction with the effect of thus repulsive interaction of ligand orbital electron to dx square minus y square dz square, they will get destabilizes. So once they get destabilizes, there has to be overcome thus destabilizing factor. To overcome thus, they will be enhances their energy, they will go away from the ligand sites. For that they will be enhances their energy and reaches to the higher energy level, and thus higher energy level as it is consisting two orbitals of dx square minus y square and dz square, thus will be doubly degenerated energy level. Like that in octahedral field, the five degenerated energy levels of d orbital will get split into triply degenerated level and doubly degenerated level. So this is what the d orbital splitting, d orbital effect affected by the crystal field. So similar, as I said that the d orbital having orbital multiplicity, orbital angular momentum, and the d term having orbital angular momentum are one and same. D orbital having an l is equal to 2, d term having also l is equal to 2. The effect of ligand field on d term can be similar or can be simply adapted for the d term. So far, so here the d term now can be expected as same splitting pattern, right? So the same splitting pattern where the d term which is having in the least energy, so the ground state term of d term, ground state term of d term, where does d term existing as a ground state term in d1 d9 configuration, they has 2d as a ground state term, and d4 d6 has the 5d ground state term. In these configurations of d1 d9 d5 d6 configured, ground state term d will get similar splitting pattern, similar effect of crystal field as d orbital affected by the crystal field. So now the d orbital d term splitting in d1 configured 2d orbital 2d term, sorry, d1 configured 2d term crystal field effect will be same to that as the d orbital splitting, right? So the d term 2d term will get participated in splitting where it reaches an lower energy level and one group will be in higher energy level. The lower energy level group will be triply degenerated state, so far it is T2G. The higher energy level is doubly degenerate level, so far it is EG level, right? That's how the 2D term of D1 electronic configuration get participated in splitting with the effect of octahedral crystal field. So then how does the 2D term in D9 electronic configuration will get in splitting? So to explain the 2D term crystal field effect in D9 electronic configuration, we have to go for Hall formalism. As per Hall formalism, D1 configuration is Hall inverse D9 electronic configuration is Hall inverse for the D1 configuration. D9 configuration is Hall inverse for D1 configuration. So as the D9 configuration is Hall inverse for the D1 configuration, the splitting pattern of D2 term of D9 configuration will be exactly reverse as it is D1 configured 2D term. So therefore, so the D2 term of D9 will have exact reverse splitting from 2D term of D2, that nothing but 2D term that has doubly degenerate state in lower energy level, triply degenerate level in higher energy level for D9 electronic configuration. So that's how the splitting takes place. Coming to the next 5D term of 5D term of
D4 configuration, where the D4, or we can say D9 configured 5D term, sorry, D6 configured 5D term. If we go D6 configured 5D term, the D6 configured 5D term has D4 only. D4 configured 5D term. D4 configured 5D term has one less electron than half filled configuration, half filled configuration of D5, and D9 has one less electron than full filled configuration of D10. So in comparison, D4 with D9, D4 is one electron less than half filled, stable half filled configuration, and D9 is also one less electron than stable configuration of full filled D10 configuration. The splitting patterns of these two D terms, of 5D term of D4, 2D term of D9, will have same splitting, will have same splitting. Therefore, they will have same splitting, which nothing but the 5D term of D4 configuration has lower energy level of doubly degenerate state, that is 5EG, higher energy level of 5T2G. Triply degenerate level in B higher energy level, doubly degenerate level B in lower energy level. And for 5D term of D6 configuration, where the D6 configuration is whole inverse of D4 configuration. So the 5D term of D6 will have reverse splitting with respect to 5D term splitting. 5D term splitting of D4 configuration, isn't it? So therefore the 5D of D6 configuration will have triply degenerate state in lower energy level and doubly degenerate state in higher energy level. This is what happens. So once again I am explaining how does it happens, the splitting pattern in D term. The D term, as it is having orbital angular momentum of 2, L is equal to 2,
when it compare with the d orbital angular moment of 2, the d orbital angular momentum, d term angular momentums are exactly one and equal, l is equal to 2, l is equal to 2. So far, the splitting pattern in the d orbital can be exactly taken as into the d term. The d term splitting pattern will be exactly same as d orbital. So where we have to know the d orbital splitting pattern. D orbital splitting pattern in octahedral will have T2g in lower energy, Eg in higher energy as per the their structural orientation with the ligand orientation. As the dx square minus y square having the orientation along the ligand sides, they will get influences, they will get repulsive interaction and get excited as in Eg level. And the dxy, dyz, dzx will have away from the ligand orientation, ligand sides. They are in between the, they have lobes in between the coordination axis, in between the ligand sides. There no repulsive interaction between ligand and electron to their electron density. So get stabilizes, gets lower in energy as T2g. So this particular d orbital splitting will be taken similarly taken into the d orbital splitting of d term splitting of d1 electronic configuration. The d term as in ground state term we can observe for the d1, d9, d4, d6 configurations will have d term as in ground state term. The splitting, the effect of weak crystal field will be in the ground state term only. The effect will be takes place in the ground state term only. Ground state term only will get affected by the crystal field, ligand field. So far it is said that weak crystal field, right? As it is influencing only on ground state term, is termed as a weak crystal field, right? In D4, D6, there will be multiple terms will exist. But here, in this all multiple states, phi d is the ground state term. So D1, D9, as it is having only one term, that will be considered as ground state term. So after all, getting the ground state term of d of these variant electronic configuration, how does the splitting pattern, once if we observe the d1 configurated 2d term will have same splitting pattern of d orbital. We can just capture and copy and paste, that will be considered as an d2 term of d1 electronic configuration. And thus d2 2d term of d1 electronic configuration has whole inversion, will have relation, whole inversion relation with the D9 electronic configuration 2D term. 2D term of D9 electronic configuration, once we compare, the D9 electronic configuration is whole inverse with the D1 electronic configuration. So far, the 2D term splitting of D9 configuration will be reversed as it is from the D2 term of the D1 electronic configuration. D1 electronic configuration. So, as D1 electronic configuration having the lower energy state of T2g, higher energy state of Eg, higher energy of Eg, so the 2d term of D9 electronic configuration will be half reverse, right? Doubly degenerated state will be in lower energy, triply degenerated state in higher energy. And extending thus splitting for the D4 electronic configuration 5d term. 5d term, where here we can compare the 4d electronic configuration as one electron less than stable electronic configuration of d5, and similar that the d9 electron configuration is also one electron less than the stable electronic configuration of d10. So comparison is saying that they are just the d9 d4 electronic configurations are just one electron less for them. Stable electronic configurations, they have similar types of splitting patterns of their ground state terms. So the D9 configurated 2D term having splitting pattern can be simply adapted for the D4 configurated 5D term. 5D term. So the 5D term of 4D configuration will again similar as 2D term of D9 electron configuration. Lower energy will be have doubly degenerated, higher energy will have triply degenerated. And when it go for the last electronic configured D term splitting pattern, that is D6 configured 5D 5D term splitting pattern, the D6 configuration is whole inverse for the D4 electronic configuration, as the D6 electronic configuration whole inverse with the D4 electronic configuration. The D4 electronic configuration 5D term splitting pattern can be reversed to the 5D term of the D6 electronic configuration. So the 5D term of D6 electronic configuration will be reverse from this particular D4 electronic configuration, because of D4 and D6 are whole inverse to one to other. So for this will be reversed to the 5D term of D6. There the triply degenerated state will be get in lower energy, doubly state energy level will be get in higher energy. And these are the four splitting patterns we can observe. So once if we change the crystal field from octahedral to octahedral to tetrahedral, when we change crystal field from octahedral to tetrahedral, octahedral to tetrahedral, the splitting patterns will get reversed. Will get reversed. Since the d orbital also get reverse its splitting from octahedral field to tetrahedral field. So as the d orbital is reversing its splitting from octahedral to tetrahedral, crystal field changing from the octahedral to tetrahedral, so here also once if we change the crystal field for the different terms, the splitting pattern also will be get reverse, right? Saying that this is D6 configured 5D term in octahedral, this in octahedral field, where if we are going with a tetrahedral, this will be get reverse. Same D5 term in D6 configured in tetrahedral will have lower energy state of doubly degenerated state of 5EG and higher energy state of 5T2G. Triply degenerated state of 5T2G will be in higher. This get just reverse in tetrahedral. So like that it takes place. And when we observe the splitting patterns of all four, we will have one statement, that is the D1 and D6 configurations will have same splitting patterns, term splitting patterns. D1 configured 2D term and D6 configured 5D term will have same splitting pattern, and D4 configured 5D term and D9 configured 2D term has same splitting pattern. So that can be said, that can be generalized as D1, so Dn and D5 plus n will have same splitting of term, and D5 minus n and D10 minus n also will have same splitting term, but the group of Dn and D5n d phi plus n to d phi minus n and d 10 minus n will be reverse splitting. We have reverse splitting. D1, D9, D5, N, 5 plus N will have same splitting pattern. D5, N, 5 minus N, D10 minus N also will have same splitting pattern. When we compare this group of splitting and this group of splitting, Dn and Dn plus N group to D5 minus N, D10 minus N group splitting patterns, once we compare, there will be inverse, right? And thus inverse also can be seen in when crystal field changes from octahedral to tetrahedral. So these two points we can observe in splitting patterns of d term, right? So here I conclude the this session of the class. By next we will be going to have F-term splitting pattern, and if time permits, we also discuss the orgel diagrams.